Hey, good morning from Tbilisi, the Republic of Georgia, and to the KTM project. Well, today I want to talk about is making a tubeless tire, which is tricky on an enduro or any spoked tire, right? Because you got all those spokes and they tend to leak, and then you got a rim lock that really leaks, and then most off-road tires are not made to be tubeless, so they will leak even through the tire. Although I've tried some that said they weren't tubeless and found they work just fine. But I guess it depends on the kind of tire you buy, which brand it is, quality, not quality. So I'm going to be mounting up, and you'll see in the video, I'll try to get to it pretty quickly here, an Anarchy Wild, which is a tubeless tire. And the method I'm going to use is different than the normal method. I'm not spending a lot of money. I'm doing it myself. It's been based on a few different videos I've seen, but I've never seen one like this before. Maybe you have. If you have, feel free and put something in the comments about it. But it's very simple and very cheap, and you can do it at home, and it works really good. So I'm going to get right into it. Tubeless tire for the KTM 450 EXE, 500, or any enduro. Or any bike with spokes, really. Simple, cheap method. So tune in, watch, and see what you tell, and let me know what you think. And if you could, hit the like button, subscribe if you like. I'm trying to build this channel a bit, and it's kind of fun for me. I'm learning how to do videos and stuff, so it's not professional videography at all. It's really just me, my phone and a simple camera in the garage. All right, so let's get to it. What I did basically is I turned my vise sideways and I put a piece of all thread in there and I slid my hollow axle onto it. So now I got a real good smooth turn there. All right, looks really good. I can, even if I want to, make sure that that doesn't fall off of there. Put my axle nut on there. And what this is going to do is it's going to give me a just something to freely spin it on, so that I can clean it, because I've got to clean all this out in here, and then I'm going to start preparing these little spoke tops here. Be careful what you say on YouTube, or might block you out. So yeah, so with this on here, I can take, for example, my wire brush. I can just spin it and put the wire brush on there, keep it spinning with the other hand when I'm not filming, and get those pretty clean in there. I may have to go around and clean each one individually, but boy, that spinning action is really nice for getting in those corners real quickly. And I can use sandpaper on there, do the same thing. I can spin it, put some of my brake cleaner on there, and do it from a distance. I can get a rag in there, and I can just real quickly, I can spin it and get it clean again. Because what I want to do is prep this surface for some glue. Okay, got it cleaned out. A little cleaned around each one of the little nipples sticking up. Okay, so I basically went around and did each one of the little nibbles there. And then I just making sure everything's covered really good. I ran my finger around and just kind of smoothed it down all the way around. I didn't want big bumps on there. Okay, so this should be sealed really good. This is material I'm using here. I'm not sure where you can get it, but it's called, let me get this around where you can see it. Elasto Seal PU25LM. Not even sure where this is available. But the reason I used it is because I tried this Elastoseal, I tried regular silicone, and I tried a couple other materials, and I took some inner tube material and I glued it to aluminum. And the thing that held the best was this stuff right here. So that's why I'm going with that. Okay, this looks a little rough now, but you can see I laid some beads in there along both sides and on the inside there. A little extra on the inside. And
I'm going to smooth that out a little bit before I get it started, but then you'll see what I'll do next. This is my plan. This is the inside of an inner tube, and I'm going to stick it around there, and I'm going to glue it down, and hopefully it's going to seal everything in there much better than tape could, and I don't need to put on a valve stem because it's already got one built into it. Probably going to take this inside piece off there, and I'll put a little piece of rubber in there so that it sits down in there better. Well, I don't really need that, but I'm going to take that bolt off there anyway, that nut, so it sits down, because there's no danger of it going back and forth. If it slips with all this glue on there, then we got a bigger problem already. So let's go ahead and slip that on there. Okay, so now I put it on, and I've smoothed it down. It's not laying perfectly, though, in there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put some tape around the outside of it to just help it kind of settle in there and get set down good. It feels like it's sealed all the way around. Right there, sticking up a little bit, that's where the valve stem is. And you see it's coming through there. So I want to put some tape to hold that down in there. Now to get the, it's going to be a nip and tuck if I can hopefully get that tire on there all right. But this is certainly a better tape than any kind of tape that they sell on the internet. This is an inner tube, and it's, because it's a size 16, it's like rubber band. It's just laying right in there because it's a size 18. So it's laid in there real tight. I had a 16 already on hand because I have my little XR100 over there, and that's a front tire for that, I believe. So now I'm going to get some tape on there, and then we'll take another look at it. Okay, so now what I did to hold the rubber down to help it to glue better is I used some masking tape, and it's actually special masking tape for painting cars and stuff. It's a very good brand. Okay, I've come out the next day and tape looks good. The glue is drying pretty good on the edges here. Okay, coming back to the wheel now. I went ahead and pulled all the tape off. It's a big ball of tape there. And I've got the rubber glued in there now. The glue feels fairly dry, but still, like it said in the advertisement, it's a little bit tacky. So, looks like it's dried out pretty good. And so I'm just putting some duct tape over the top of it to kind of protect it for when I put the tire on there. It doesn't push the rubber sideways. I guess it still could, but this is hopefully going to help. But this isn't necessarily to stop air from escaping, but might help. But the rubber should be enough to do that. Well, I got that on there pretty tight now. I'm just gonna massage it down a bit. Air out of there. Wanna make sure I cut a little hole in there for the valve stem so I can still get air inside. My high-tech tool called a pen. Okay. Okay. Okay, I got it to sit on the rim. Oh boy, it took some real bouncing, and I had to pump it up to about 80 pounds, and it finally got set on the rim. But I'm, you know, got spraying my soapy water everywhere, and I'm not seeing any leaks so far. So what I'm going to do is I'll let it sit for a little while. Maybe work on just checking out the balance on it and stuff now that the tire's on here, and see how it works. So far, so good. Okay, so I bet you're wondering, how does it turn out? How did it go? Does it actually hold air? Well, I can say now I've got over 5,000 kilometers on it, and it's still holding air really good. It's Anarchy Wild, good tire, but the method works good. It's a sound method, so I recommend it. I will say once I did manage to get the tire off the bead, but that's when I lowered the air pressure down a lot because I was stuck on the hill, and I got to the top of the hill and I got stuck in the mud and kind of had wrenched the bike sideways to get it out. I think that's what popped it off the rim, and I didn't even notice it right away. And I was able to, just wash around the rim, get the mud out, and got it refilled with air, no problem. The problem was the low air pressure. And in this method, I don't have a rim lock on there. So you do have to be careful dropping air. Make sure you measure it carefully. You can also use, if you like, in there just for insurance, you can get some of the slime and put that in there. It works. It helps. Although I'm not sure it's necessary at all. But if you do have a leak of some sort, you can put some in there and that should do it. But the tire, the inner tube should be enough. Okay, try it out. It cost me hardly anything. It cost me one inner tube that I already had on hand and basically one bottle of the glue that I recommended in the video. So, okay, be blessed. Happy trails.